So friends, in the last class, previous lecture, iron carbide equilibrium diagram was covered. You have also drawn the diagram. Okay, today we are going to study the details of the diagram. What are the number of phases? What are the transformations? What are the important temperatures on the diagram? So you open your diagram. Already I have drawn it earlier. Now I will explain you with reference to your figure in the notebook. Keep the diagram in front of you. Okay. Now let us familiar with the number of phases. I have told you there are number of phases starts from room temperature to higher temperature. So write down the title, number of phases on the diagram. Phases on FE-FE-3C diagram. Pay attention. Now, let us start with the room temperature phase. The first phase is alpha dash ferrite. Right? The way in which I have written. Alpha dash ferrite. See here, how to define it? In the examination, question will be asked. As I told, draw the grid sketch of iron carbide equilibrium diagram and explain various phases present on it, temperatures on it, etc., etc. So whenever it is asked, explain various phases on which, what you are supposed to write. You have to write a definition first. So I am going to define it. Just remember, I will dictate you later. Alpha ferrite. It is interstitial solid solution of carbon in alpha FCCI, alpha BCCI. I repeat once again. It is interstitial solid solution of carbon in alpha BCCI. BCC stands for body centered cubic structure. It is soft, ductile, deformable. Maximum solubility of carbon in alpha ferrite is, just take your notebook, you have drawn in the notebook. Maximum solubility of carbon in alpha ferrite is 0.025 at 727 degree Celsius and 0.008 at room temperature. Now why it is called as ferrite? This ferrite word comes from ferrum. Almost pure iron. See the percentage of carbon, very negligible. So it is almost pure iron. It's come with the name Latin word ferrum. That's why it is called as ferrite. And it is also known as low temperature ferrite. Okay. Then second phase on the diagram is delta ferrite. Same definition. Both are ferrites. Only the difference is appearance. Second phase appears at higher temperature and first one appears at lower temperature. So I am defining the delta ferrite. It is the interstitial solid solution of carbon in delta BCC ion at higher temperature. This word is important, at higher temperature. Interstitial solid solution of carbon in delta BCC. Again it is BCC, body centered cubic. At higher temperature. It is again soft, that time everything is applicable to it. It is actually, see, why we have given different symbol delta? You may say, sir, why we are not using alpha? Because it is also BCC. The answer to this question is, we want to differentiate it. Otherwise, how can we differentiate? So for lower temperature BCC structure, name given is alpha ferrite, and for higher temperature BCC structure, name given is delta ferrite. That is the difference. Third phase is austenite, gamma dash austenite. As I told you in last lecture, this phase was invented or studied by the scientist Sir Austin. Sir Austin. So, whenever he was observing the microstructure, he observed that at particular temperature or above particular temperature, BCC does not remain BCC. BCC structure changes to FCC. So it is face center cubic. So it is not BCC, means it is not ferrite. That's why he has to give some different name. And he has given name as a he common name as a austenite to the face. And gamma is the symbol used for it. So how I am going to define austenite check? It is interstitial solid solution of carbon in gamma FCCI. Gamma FCCI. It is solid solution of carbon in gamma FCCIN. So you remember these phases by the crystal structure. Alpha is BCC, delta is BCC, and this gamma is FCC. So these are the three important phases. Now, whenever with heating and cooling system at different temperature you study the diagram, you will observe another phases, which is mixture of two phases. But before I go to that mixture of two phases, fourth important phase is remaining, and that is cementite. Cementite is Fe3C. Fe3C. It is also called as iron carbide. It is also called as iron carbide. That's why name of our diagram is iron carbide equilibrium diagram. Because at left hand side this pure iron is present, and right hand side 100% cementite is present. Remember my statement. Cementite is the hardest phase in the system. I repeat once again. Cementite is the hardest phase in the system. Now we have two more phases you are not familiar with. That is bainite and martensite. But cementite is harder than bainite and martensite also. You will come across with these two phases in section 2. But time being you remember, cementite is the hardest phase in the system. So alpha ferrite, delta ferrite, BCC, they are soft. FCC is again more soft. Austenite is softer because it is present at higher temperature. Cementite is the hardest phase. It is not solid solution, remember. It is the compound. So its structure is not like FCC, BCC, but its structure is orthorhombic. So you have studied 14 previous lattices. Okay, BCC, FCC, base center to be, body center to be, face center to be, orthorhombic, hexagonal close, HCP, hexagonal close back, BCT, body center, tetragonal, etc., etc. So that part is not your studied in the physics. So this is orthorhombic structure which is hard. Okay, now I was telling about mixture of two phases. At 0.8% of carbon, I repeat once again, at 0.8% of carbon, the phase perlite, it is a mixture of alpha plus Fe3C. When percentage of carbon in the steel is 0.8 and you are cooling from austenitic zone, as soon as you cross 727 line, 727 degree Celsius line, in one stroke austenite FCC is converted into mixture of BCC plus orthorhombic. So this mixture of BCC plus orthorhombic is called as perlite. Why the name perlite is given? Because it shines like pearl below the microscope. This phase is again hard or soft? Tell me logical answer. Perlite is hard or soft? Now compare whether ferrite is soft or perlite is soft. Whether ferrite is soft or perlite is soft? Ferrite is soft, perlite should be hard. Why? Because it contains cementite. I repeat once again. Ferrite is soft or perlite is soft? Answer is ferrite is soft, because perlite is having ferrite plus cementite, one of the hard phases present. If I will ask, cementite is hard or perlite is hard? Cementite is hard, because perlite consists of little soft phase which reduces hardness. So comparatively, you have to remember. There are two types of perlite, globular perlite, laminar perlite. So during the heat treatment process, I will explain tell you what is meaning of blue mirror and upper light. Okay, and you remember. Next, fifth one is lead fluoride. If done, you see your INR carbon diagram. At 4.3% of carbon, see your notebook. At 4.3% of carbon, liquid is converted into mixture of austenite plus cementite. L that gives gamma plus Fe3C, and that is eutectic reaction. Which one? Eutectic reaction. At 4.3% of carbon, 1137 degree Celsius, when you are cooling liquid that gives austenite plus cementite, that mixture is called as lead fluoride. So these are the number of phases present. Understood? Right on.
It is a compound.
maximum solubility of carbon is 6.67. Maximum solubility of carbon is 6.67%. Pip per light. Underline dash. It is mixture of ferrite and cementite. It is mixture of ferrite and cementite. It is present 100% at 0.8% of carbon. So it is present 100% at 0.8% of carbon. Next, lead chloride. LeadBurite. It is mixture of austenite and cementite. It is mixture of austenite and cementite and 4.3% of carbon. And 4.3% of carbon. Next slide. Types of steels. Types of steels. Pay attention now.